Well, you can't come to Mobile, Alabama without coming to see this. USS Alabama battleship. They have more than just the battleship here. They have a submarine, SR-71, B-52s, lots of other different aircraft, tanks. This is the resting spot. Since, I think, 1965, it's been here. Look at that, it even has its little radar thing going on top. So we'll go in, we'll look around, and I'll be showing you the sights. This is the B-52 Calamity Jane, which they used during Vietnam. It's got the nighttime camouflage, since they used it mainly in nighttime. They have some other things over here. Oh, I forgot to mention it was $4 to get in for parking. If you want to go on the battleship, I think it's $15, $13 if you're senior over 55. And there are other prices for AA members and things like that. There's the submarine. We have the SR-71 Blackbird, which are currently not in commission. These cool wooden decks. A lot of guns. It's pretty scary to be behind one of these. Aim this gun. More like a cannon. Wow. They haven't even gone below deck yet. Those are some big chains. It's as thick as my arm. And my arms are pretty thick. At the front of the ship. Here's the rest of the park. So this is called a paravane. They'd put it out at the side of the ship and it would collect the mines, any mines that were in the area, snag them basically, and they would come to the surface and then they could shoot at them. Officers' quarters. They even got their own sink. One level down.
There's
the turret.
Okay, so then the
more officers' quarters. The support for the gun turrets up above. Bunks. Don't look comfortable. Another gun turret support. Marine supply room. Around the support structure of the turrets, they have the spare gun barrels for the 40mm. This is where they kept them. Good to have spare parts. Hologram. Thought he was real.
Copy that. Understood. Captain, I'm not going to be happy to do that. No way around it, though. Alright, Clarence,
Let's go down another deck. Information center, combat information center.
The activities of the CIC also assisted the commanding officer in search and rescue, navigation, piloting, and tactical maneuvers. The CIC was often under the immediate supervision of the executive officer.
Central Station, it says. This is where the gyroscope compass. Here's the level where the shells came up to go up to the turret. These shells are each 2,700 pounds and could be shot out of those guns 22 miles away. Here's sick bay. They would actually even take your tonsils out. They'd do anything that you needed done. the operating room. This place is endless and it's a maze. Another operating room. And this is the hospital. Like I said, this place is a maze. Dentist office. This is gonna be one long video. Radio Central again. Morse code, monitoring different radio frequencies, listening to the enemy. Go up topside with conveyors. They send it up top. More room here, I assume, for shells. This is the lower handling room for the smaller guns up top. I can show here where we are. Sends all the... Here's the room where it has... These are all empty casings in here. But we'd send the... Load the ammo and send it up top to the guns. We are yet at another lower... deck. Looks like all the electrical circuit breakers and stuff are down here. Oh, hello. Wow. It's a lot of switches. And fuses. Wow. And we're going down yet again. I assume this is the engine room. It's really crowded with pipes. Wow. There's even a level below this. The shaft there. There's a lot to this ship. Can you imagine what all these things do? Boilers. Steam. And they say if one of these lines broke or a plane hit or something was damaged, that the steam coming out of these would cut you in half. Main area. Let's see what's for lunch. They had their own bakery down here. There's the dining area. Here's where you can buy your candy bars and cigarettes and shaving lotion. And the eating quarters go on. There's several rooms full of these places to eat. More bunks. And photography room. Just a black room. Tailor shop. Gotta have a tailor. I'm telling you, these are really tough to get through. Barbershop. This place is endless. Been in here for over an hour. And I still haven't gone up to the upper level yet. They have their own prison too. The brig. Machine shop. Blacksmith shop. Nice quarters here. Must be the commander. Yep, captain's cabin and captain's dining. Let's go inside one of these guns. Two little seats in here. Targeting. Put the shell in there. We're gonna go inside this big gun. I think they're 16-inch guns. Here's where you come to shoot the gun, the big one. Looks like you sit right here. It's like big periscopes or something. Huh. It's like a lens on either end of this. Wow. here is where the gun turns. Yep, that's a periscope on either end. Interesting. There's a lot of stuff in here to know about. I guess on the USS Wisconsin, when they used it for the Iraq War, they tried to hook this up to a computer and it didn't work for accuracy. They had to bring out some World War II vets out of retirement and have them teach Iraqi or US Navy how to shoot these guns because they were more accurate without a computer. This is the battle bridge. Periscopes and stuff. It's hard to see in there. I've taken so much video, I'm almost out of battery. Here's where they do their Morse code from. There's one on each side. We can't get to the very, very top. I went up two or three other flights, but the very, very top is blocked off. Here is the aircraft pavilion. Obviously some not World War II era.
The courage of your heart rather than the color of your skin that makes all the difference.
F-18, F-16, F-15. A-4, A-7 Corsair, looks like an F-14. A little mini sub here. Doesn't really, oh wait, it does say what it is over here. Let's go look. Oh, Confederate, 1864. Look at the propulsion. Bunch of guys cranking on the prop. Interesting. PT boat and USS Drum submarine. So this is what a submarine is like. I don't know how well these guns work once they were submerged. I guess they did. It's the whole park.
You want to get down?
Sure.
take it this is the torpedo room. Forward torpedoes. Like a kitchen. Quarters. Dining. More quarters. Guess that's where they steer from. Oh, here's the kitchen. Freezer down there. Refrigerator. More bunks. The forward engine room. These are the diesel engines that they use when they're on the surface. These are all for the batteries. Because it's run on battery power when underwater. And these are the aft torpedoes. So they use every bit. This is the aft torpedo. They have beds. They have this rail that they keep the torpedoes on. And this rail, these come down. And this rail moves over. Slides over. Slides the torpedo over. So it can go through here. So that whole rail slides over. So the torpedo can go straight into the launch tube. This is the aft end of the sub. You can see the aft torpedoes, two on each side. Thank you. nobody really knows you can get up here. But I found a way up. You can see everything from up here.